Facebook has unfriended Australia because it says it has been misunderstood. An angry Australia has also spoken to their mutual friends, including India, over teaching Facebook a lesson. Google too had posted on Australia's wall, threatening to unfriend it. But now Google has grudgingly told the countries that it wants to stay friends with them. This, in a nutshell, is how the spat between the Australian government and big tech is unfolding over the issue of getting Facebook and Google to pay news publishers for displaying the news content on their platforms. Australia is almost ready to bring a law that will require these companies like Facebook and Google to strike commercial deals with media companies within 90 days. According to the government, the law will provide better bargaining powers to these news companies who've struggled for ad revenues in the past, while Google and Facebook have lined their pockets. Now, Google has agreed and already struck multi-million dollar deals with three of Australia's largest media companies. But Facebook has done the opposite and blocked news from its platform altogether. In this video, we'll explain why this is a big deal and affects all of us. In order to understand this complex fight between the government, big tech companies, and news publishers, we'll explore three vital questions. One, why Google agreed to pay news companies, but Facebook did not? Two, will this reset the relationship between news publishers and big tech news aggregators? And three, why is it important to India and the world? Facebook estimates that only about 4% of posts on the network is news content. Google similarly says that news-related queries accounted for just 1% of the total queries in Australia. Make no mistake, Google had threatened to take an even more extreme step than Facebook and pull out its search service altogether from Australia. So why did Google not go the Facebook way? Simply put, Facebook can afford to do this, but Google cannot. Search is what Google cares about, and removing links to news stories from Google would splinter the search engine in Australia, opening it up to rivals like Microsoft Bing and Yahoo. Even though it enjoys a market share of over 95%, Google does not want to expose its users in any country to its rivals' services. Facebook has no such problems though. This brings us to our second question. Does this reset the relation between news publishers and news aggregators? Or can this revenue sharing equation be changed easily? The word relation here is especially important. Facebook has said that the proposed Australian law fails to recognize the fundamental nature of the relationship between our platform and publishers. So in doing so, Facebook has made it clear that it will not let revenue sharing equations change so easily. And even if the relationship is reset, it will not be reset on the terms set by the government or any of these publishers. Zuckerberg and co have emphasized that it brings much more value to news publishers than they do for Facebook. Facebook said it has sent more than 5 billion clicks to Australian publishers, whose value they estimate to be around 407 million Australian dollars. Also, since 2016, and this is important to note, Facebook actively prioritized favoring posts from our friends and family on our timelines over posts from news publishers. And on 18th February, Facebook showed that it can block news and still thrive. But the question is, can publishers, especially smaller independent ones, do without the traffic that they get from Facebook? So, the relationship has, of course, been an unequal one, and Facebook wants to make it clear who is calling the shots here and bringing in the revenue. This brings us to our third and final question. Why are these developments in Australia important for the world, especially India? It is clear at this point that this isn't just about news publishers. This has also blown up into a fight between the governments and Facebook. Every major country is currently trying to cut the Facebooks and the Googles of the world to size and make them much more accountable. Be it over issues of news revenue, privacy, misinformation, or antitrust abuse of monopoly. The EU, US, Canada, India, and others are all trying hard to clamp down on big tech's unchecked powers. But here's the thing. Australia's proposed law has also been severely criticized about concerns that it would simply transfer more money from the tech platforms to big media houses like News Corp and do very little for the smaller independent journalists or publications. As of now, Google has struck deals with three of Australia's largest media companies, including Rupert Murdoch's, which have sparked serious concerns of concentration of powers in the media industry while smaller publications languish. Importantly, the proposed law also says nothing about media houses using this money to create more journalism jobs or pay journalists better or spend more on news gathering or bolstering strong, serious journalism. So, while Facebook or Google blocking news wouldn't deal a death blow to, say, a News Corp, it would severely affect smaller news organizations. In conclusion, one hopes that the current fight is ultimately as much about journalism and news as much as it is about balance sheets of large companies and egos of governments.